Hey, what's going on? It's your boy Brandon Berg. What's going on up in the South? You know, it's today, Sunday. Just got done working on my car, man. My car, the alternator was shot. The battery kind of went dead. So the whole weekend, I pretty much was trying to get this sucker fixed. You know what I'm saying? I spent some major money. Got killed financially on the pockets wise, but you know, that's life. What can I say? But Yeah, man, I really wanted to jump in on, do another fun fact of history. I really want to talk about the Cinco de Mayo. I'm going to try to make it really short, but go, you know, but also, you know, give you the historic content as well. But I'm going to try to simplify it and also try to just bring in a little bit shorter term. But, you know, a lot of people celebrate Cinco de Mayo. And, you know, I know a lot of Mexicans and stuff, they like to get it, you know, they like to get it cracking. You know what I'm saying? They like to get, you know, drink their Bud Lights and shit. And, you know, I mean, for some reason they love Bud Light. They, you know, I don't know why Bud Light, not, it tastes like water, but they like their Bud Light. But, you know, they cry, drink a lot of beer and stuff like that and have this, you know, and they just drink, you know what I'm saying? Even though a lot of them don't really know why. I mean, some people can somewhat, some Mexicans actually know, Mexican-Americans, they kind of know a little bit of the reason behind the Cinco de Mayo, but really a lot of people don't know the reason of Cinco de Mayo. But, and that's Spanish term for, you know, May the 5th. Mayo 5th, Cinco is 5, so that's what it is. But yeah, I really wanted to go behind the Cinco de Mayo and the origin of it. But you know, it's kind of actually it's very weird, and it's a very awkward moment. And that's like a symbolic win for them, but it was a base like a losing effort. It was coming from the Franco-Mexican War. That was between France and Mexico. Now, the war started December 1861, and it ended at, I think, June of 1867. Now, this war with Mexico was kind of going on during the American Civil War. So, you know, at the time, Napoleon III, he was the instigator. Convinced Spain and British to, he was propping up like a free trade, like a global free trade. But he knew that South America and Central America had a lot of wealth and a lot of gold, primary silver, definitely in Mexico, because he wanted to take over Mexico. He take over Mexico, he got the gateway to a lot of South American resources and so forth. So, it was a motariat there. So he convinced, it was in the treaty, the Treaty of London, I think it was signed in like 1861. All three countries invaded Mexico. Now they took like three Mexico states. They took Arizuba, Veracruz, and I think they took Exilba, something like that. But I butchered some of these Mexican states' names. I apologize, they kind of held into it. Actually, they took the states and they kind of like surrounded it. But this was only the three states that they were basically agreed to take over, but not to actually invade Mexico because it was over debt. You know what I'm saying? It was over debt. You know, Mexican owned France a lot of money, and from doing trade and doing their doing wars and other stuff like that. So it was based like a war, really over money, but it became something that was beyond just money. And the European mindset, they feel like, look, if you owe me money, I'm taking everything. You know what I'm saying? That's their way of basically paying the price of their debt. But you know, so far I'm gonna keep it 100 with you. And you know, by 1862, France and Spain and British actually kind of learned the motive of France, really. It wasn't just about this forcing them to pay. It was that he was just really want to take it all over for himself. So they pulled out. So, you know, the French went on to continue to take more territory. And they literally took almost 80% of the country. You know what I'm saying? They went all the way up to Monterey. They already took over the central and southern part of Mexico. They were just pushing up towards Monterey and to Guadalupe and all that. And there was a battle called, you know, the Battle of Puebla. Now that was like the first one of the first, but almost like the last battles that they won against the French. And that's what they call, you know, that's basically what they celebrate. That's where Cinco de Mayo really is celebrated, just that one battle. Now, I told a lot of people when I read, you read the history, it's crazy because, the French was very strategic when they attacked Mexico. Because they knew during the time, you know, the United States was in their civil war. So the United States had to, you know, I mean, they really couldn't do much. Now, they started selling a lot of arms and supplies around 1865. But that was almost pretty much after the end of the Civil War. But they came with the Monroe Doctrine. Now, the Monroe Doctrine was actually a letter present to give it to the French government of Napoleon III, and it was a letter that said it's an act of war if you continue to keep attacking and taking over territory of Mexico. And that letter was sent to him in 1867. It was 1865. I think they sent it in 1865. Within 2 years. Well, now, really, the French, I'm going to say the French actually left. They actually got out of there. But during their takeover, and I think when they captured Mexico City, there was a French nationalist named Maximilian. Now, he was crowned the new king of the Mexican-French Empire. And so that's when Napoleon put him in. He said, okay, I'm going to crown you as the ruler of the new Mexican Empire, the French Mexican Empire. So he was basically in charge of, solidifying Mexico. So, and they were taking many territories. I mean, they practically took over almost close to 70 to 80% of Mexico at this time. Until that, the Monroe Doctrine was sent to France, and it told France it'd be an act of war. Now, the act of war, if the United States would declare war, British would declare war because they're already treaty. They have a treaty ally. They sign an ally. Whatever two of them, if they ever go into war, each other will have their back. So, France really didn't want British. Britain to really declare war on them as well. That'd just be too much. So they actually started withdrawing. And they withdrew like that same year they withdrew, leaving the Mexican Empire forces led by Maximilian to fight the Republican. But by that time, that's when America was sending many arms, many supplies to the Mexican revolutionary. That was basically the rebels. And they eventually start taking back their country back. And by 1867, they captured Maximilian. They executed him. But the reason why they executed him, because during the war, Napoleon had ordered a black decree on all Mexicans that was captured during the Franco-Mexican War. If you're a Mexican, you get captured, you go in immediately execution. They'll kill you. They won't even hold you for being a prisoner. So that was like their revenge for all the Mexicans that was captured, that was executed. that was, they executed Maximilian, you know what I'm saying? No, he was, he, France did try to plead to him, like, hey, don't kill him, you know what I'm saying? He's not, you know, you can send him to prison or whatever like that, but he, you know, but they actually kind of like just, they really didn't help the dude, you know what I'm saying? They basically just kind of just let him just get executed. Him and a couple other people, one of his generals, they're all through France. I think France, they're a Mexican national, but they fought with the French side. They got executed. But the thing about, I tell a lot of people, Mexico would have been completely France during that time. But they sent the letter to basically Napoleon, and he basically withdrew it immediately. You know what I'm saying? So I told this to a lot of people. Mexicans actually should be very grateful to a lot of Americans, to the United States. I won't say Americans. I'll just say United States as a whole. But because the United States basically saved Mexico. You know what I'm saying? You guys celebrate one battle that you guys, I mean, just one battle. You guys just won one battle. If it wasn't for that letter, you guys would have been speaking French. Mexico would be speaking, it would be no longer Spanish. It'd be France. But yeah, the war ended like in June of 1867, and they regained their independence. But that just lets you know the extent. Mexicans can say all what they want, but you know they were always assisted on their victories. I mean, there were some victories that they maybe did themselves, but they always had to have help with a victory. Like I always said, you know, people celebrate Cinco de Mayo, but I said, that's just one battle. They were getting their asses whooped in that entire war. You know what I'm saying? And I think the casualty wasn't that much. I think it was about 14,000 died, about 12,000 died, Mexicans died, soldiers died in the war. Versus like with France and the Mexican Empire, they lost like 14,000. Probably majority was from the Mexican Empire. But like the twos, there's no loyalty when you look at Mexico. I told a lot of dudes, yeah, France did a lead, but Mexico was actually finding Mexicans. You was actually finding each other. So yeah, you had an outside source come and invade, but at the end, you're fighting your own people that aligned themselves with the France. So it was like, it turned to an invasion. It went from an invasion, turned to a civil war. You know what I'm saying? So that's the craziest thing about it. You guys are celebrating France, but at the end of the war, you guys were fighting each other. You was fighting other Mexican nationalities that basically confessed their loyalty to the French crown. You know what I'm saying? So, very confusing there. That's a lot of confusion. That's a lot of disloyalty in my book. That's a lot of disloyalty. But yeah, that's really that's really the origin of the Cinco de Mayo, with just one battle, the Battle of Puebla. But yeah, that's really, like I said, a lot of people celebrate shit, don't even know what it is. You know, like I said, nobody really don't celebrate the Haiti victory and shit. So to myself, why I'm gonna celebrate another group victory? You know what I'm saying? You know, plus it wasn't really a victory to them. I mean, they had to be helped, you know what I'm saying, to win their victory. While the Haiti basically, they basically fought just them versus three colonial power with no help. So, they went around South America and Mexico trying to eliminate the people from their oppression. So, you have to just look at it at that way. You have to dissect it that way. But yeah, like I said, man, that's my fun fact of history about Cinco de Mayo. And I'll probably get with you guys tomorrow. Man, I don't know what type of video I'm going to make. I'm really, I don't know, I'm gonna keep going with the fun facts, or I'm gonna probably just break some just regular commentary. But I don't know, like I said, man, whatever it is, I'm gonna make it juicy and hot. All right, one.